Hi everyone, how are you today? Welcome back to ICTEM for Kindergarten, where you learn, I learn, we all learn about the ICTEM. And this is Hong. Today, we are going to learn a new root operation. Then, we are going to do a small quiz together. And lastly, as usual, I'm going to give you the homework. Before I start, I have a question for you. Let's say this is your house, where you live in for many years, and this is your street size. Let's say tomorrow, your local city decides to change your street name and your house number. My question for you is, can you find your house? Are you kidding me, huh? What kind of question is that? Of course, I live there. I know it by heart. I can't even find it in the dark. Alright. By the same token, let's say this is the house of your knowledge, your understanding about a subject or a procedure, why and how it's done. And tomorrow, the government decides to change your street name from CPT-4 to CPT-5, or ICD-9 to ICD-10, or even ICD-11. And they give you the new map of how it's categorized or structured. Can you still find your house? In other words, the code for that procedure. Of course, it's happened there since day one. Exactly, that's the point that I try to make. If you know your surgery and procedures, I don't care what coding system that they want to use. You should be able to find the right code for that procedure. This is you. You have a full control of what you want to learn. And this is the external cause, something that you have no control over. If you decide, I've got to know this stuff for my own knowledge and for my career, then we better get started now. Today, we're going to learn a new root operation, and it's called extirpation. Here's the definition. Taking or cutting out solid matter from a body part. The solid matter can be categorized into two groups. Abnormal byproducts of a biological function and a foreign body. First, abnormal byproduct of a biological function refer to kidney stones, gallbladder stone, thrombus or a blood clot, etc. Second, the solid matter also refer to a foreign body. For example, children may book objects into their nose or their mouth while playing. The objects may include food, small toys, eraser, cones, button, etc. A box in your ear is also considered a foreign body. A word of precaution is that do not confuse between the foreign body and therapeutic device like pacemaker, defibrillator, portacap, etc. We will learn how to code the removal of this device later on. This is the x-ray of a patient, probably a psychotic patient, who swallowed foreign body in the GI tract. You can tell there are nails, and this looked like a medicine bottle to me. Sorry, this is a crow image of a roach chilling in the right external auditory canal. I'm sure it's nice and warm in there, so he's just chilling and minds nobody's business. This is Billy, the exterminator. My son and I love to watch his show. If you have time, please check it out. Basically, people call him when they found bugs, bees, cockroaches, snakes, raccoons, or alligators in their houses. When I picture him, the exterminator, it sounds like extirpation. So it helps me to remember this operation. Bill come to rescue, getting the bugs out of my ear. Ouch. Let's say a doctor removed the foreign body from the right external auditory canal endoscopically. How are we going to call this procedure? First, this is medical and surgical procedure. So 0 is the first character. Please go ahead and click on it. This will lead you to the second character, which is the body system. What is the body system of the ear? You can see here, ear, nose, and sinus. Please click on it. This will lead you to the third character, which is the root operation. You already know the objective of this procedure is to remove the bugs from your ear, and it's called extirpation. And you have the right table here, 09C. Click on it. Okay, what is the body part? Right external auditory canal. So I see here three external auditory canal. So on the right, what is the approach? It's done endoscopically. So we have A here, via natural to your ears, and no device left in place and no qualifier. So what is the final code? 09C38GG. How you doing? I hope you got it right. Let's do one more case together. What is the IC10 BCS code for this procedure? Transurethral cystoscopy with removal of bladder stone. Please pause the video and go back to the IC10 BCS table now. First, this medical and surgical procedure, so 0 is the first character. Please go ahead and click on it. This will lead you to the second character, which is the body system. What is the body system of the bladder? It should be urinary system. Please click on it. This will lead you to the third character, which is the root operation. You already know the objective of this procedure is to remove the stone from the bladder, and it's called extirpation. So you have the right table here, 0DC. Click on it. Okay. What is the body part? It's the bladder. So we have B is the value of the four character. And what is the approach? It's done endoscopically. Transurethral, it means via natural. So we have 8 is the value of the fifth character. There's no device left in place and no qualifier. So what is the final code? 0TCB8GG. How are you doing so far? It's not that bad, is it? In review, we talk about the root operation extirpation. We talk about two types of solid matter, abnormal byproduct and foreign body. Before we're done, here's your homework. What is the IC10 BCS code for this procedure? Foreign body removal, skin up left thumb. That's all for now. I hope that you learned something new today. Thank you so much for watching. And I also want to say thank you for taking the time to send me emails and comments. I really appreciate it. Until next time, have a great day.